Hi there, my name is Dimitri and this tutorial will cover how to track time in Clockify through the web app and browser extension. We'll also cover all the settings and preferences that'll make your time tracking effortless. First, open up Clockify in your browser and log in. Once you're inside the app, you'll see the time tracker at the top. Here you can start the timer or manually log your activity. Let's see how the timer works. When you start working on something, click Start and the timer will start counting. Notice that the icon has a red dot next to it indicating that the timer is running even if you're in another tab. While the timer is running, you can write what you're working on, and then stop the timer when you're finished. And we have it! You've created your first entry. Here you can see the total time you've tracked today. When you want to start working on the activity again, click on the play button right next to the time entry. This will start a new timer for that activity so you don't have to add all the details again. In case you started working before you started the timer, click on the time and enter your real start time. If you wish to cancel the timer, click on the three dots and discard it. You can also split running or existing time entries longer than 2 minutes into two by clicking on the three dots and choosing at which point you want to split the entry. Then you can correct any details in case you forgot to switch between projects or tasks you've been working on. Your time entries can be saved as favorites. Go to the workspace settings to enable favorite entries. And you'll see the option to add an entry as a favorite when you click on the three dots next to it. This will create a shortcut below the timer so you can quickly start them again with the same information. You can also quickly start them with keyboard shortcuts that are automatically created based on the order in which you added your favorites to the list. You can have up to 5 favorite entries. So in case you need a new one, hover over to an existing one that you no longer need and then click on the star sign to remove it. Each time entry has a billable sign that determines its billability, so you know what can be billed to clients. If the currency sign is blue, the entry is billable. And if you uncheck it, it'll turn gray, which means it's no longer billable. This can also always be changed in the reports. And you can even hide it completely in the workspace settings if you don't use billable rates. In case you need more details on each time entry, you can create custom fields in the form of text, number, link, switch button, or selection list to choose from multiple options. If you want to track your breaks in the same way that you track your time entries, you need to enable it in the workspace settings and assign a default break project. Then go to the tracker, switch to the break mode here, and the break will start. You'll notice the break entries have a different icon so you can easily distinguish them from time entries. Once you finish your break, you can stop the timer and add any additional details. Break entries can also be split, duplicated, and saved as favorites. You can also add time for past activities manually. First, switch to manual mode here, enter the activity, the start and end times, and then click Add. If the activity didn't happen today, you can also click on the calendar, choose the date, and add time retroactively. A quick way you can log time is to duplicate an existing entry. Find the entry you wish to log again, click on Options, Duplicate, and then change the date. Duplicating is also useful when you want to add an entry but can't use the manual mode because the timer is already running. In case you wish to fix an entry or add more information, you can edit it at any time by clicking on what you wish to edit, like this. If you wish to delete an entry, you can do it here. You can also mass edit entries by turning on the bulk edit mode here. Then you can select entries, click Bulk Edit, check what you wish to update, enter the new value and save. If you're an admin, you can edit your team's entries in the detailed report the same way. Let's say you want to disable editing or adding time manually. You can go to the workspace settings and enable Force Timer. After which, users won't be able to switch to manual mode or edit the start and end times of their existing time entries. Another way to prevent editing is to lock time entries before a specific day on a weekly or monthly basis. Or you could lock all entries before a specific date. Workspace and profile settings give you the ability to customize your time tracking data in a few ways. First of all, you can categorize your time in multiple ways. By default, track time is organized through clients, projects, and tasks. But you can change those labels to something that works better for your organization. such as department, location, and job area. Or customize them however you wish. You can choose the format in which track time will be displayed, with hours, minutes, and seconds, or just hours and minutes, or just hours. Depending on the number formatting in your country, Clockify gives you a few options to choose from to display numbers in a way that's suitable for your country's standards. For even more options, open your profile preferences. Whatever you set as a preference will only be reflected in your personal view and will not affect the other users. Here you can change your Clockify theme from light to dark and choose the language you want to use within the app. Grouping determines if the same entries will be grouped together on the tracker page. If you wish to see each entry separately and in chronological order, you can turn off grouping. Compact project list gives you a way to customize how your project list will be displayed on the tracker page. You can choose to collapse all projects and the list won't be visible until you expand it. Another option is that you can choose to not collapse the list and all projects will be listed. Or define the number that will trigger the collapse. By enabling the task filter, you can quickly find a specific task by typing the task name and add project name, which is quite useful when you have a lot of tasks with the same name on different projects. If you keep the task filter off, the search filter will take into account projects and clients. You can choose the time zone in which you'll be working, the date format, opt for the 12-hour or 24-hour format, and choose on which day of the week and what time your work week will start. Now I'll go over some tips and tricks on how to use Clockify more efficiently. Let's start with keyboard shortcuts. In the web app, you can navigate using only your keyboard. When you're in the description field, you can start a timer by pressing the down arrow on your keyboard, and then selecting one of the most recent activities. Or you can start typing and get a suggestion based on previously tracked activities. If the keyword is found in either description, project, client, task, or tag, you'll see it. If it's a new activity, you can type what you're working on, hit tab, search for the project, and press down to select a project. Expand the task list by pressing right, select with enter, and tab your way to the next field. You can start the timer by pressing Escape to deselect any currently active field, and then press N to start the timer. To stop the timer, press S. To continue the latest entry, press C. You can also switch to manual mode by pressing M. When you're in manual mode and you're in the start, end, date, or duration field, you can press up and down to increment time. You can also enter the duration in a variety of formats. For example, you can enter 1 or 1m, or 1h or 1.5, and so on. Navigating the project list, if you have hundreds of projects and tasks, can make finding the right one difficult. One solution is to use favorites. Next to each project is a star. When you click on it, that project will be added to your favorites, and it'll always appear on top. Another solution is to search for the project by typing the project's name or the client it belongs to. If you're using tasks a lot, be sure to turn on the task filter in workspace settings. Then, when you type something, Clockify will filter by tasks instead of projects. You can still filter by project, only you'll need to use the @ prefix like this. Everything you type before the @ character will be filtered by task, and everything after will be filtered by project and client. You can resize the project list by dragging the corner in case you can't see enough. Or you can open a list in a new window by clicking on the expand icon in the right corner. Now you have much more space to find what you're looking for. If you're tracking time and need a new project, you can create a new one quickly. Just open the list, type the name of the new project, and create it using your mouse or keyboard. You can also create clients and tags the same way. Just open the list, type a new name, and create. In addition to the Clockify web app, you can also install Clockify on your mobile or computer for greater convenience. So no matter where you track time from, all the data is synced online and available from anywhere. Clockify desktop apps are available for Mac, Windows, and Linux, while mobile apps are available for iOS and Android. Desktop and mobile apps have plenty of useful features, such as automatic time tracking and mobile widgets. For more information about mobile and desktop apps, check out our dedicated video tutorials in the description. Another way to track time on the web without opening the app is through the Clockify browser extension. The extension is available for Chrome, Firefox, or Edge. Install it on your browser, pin it for easier access, and you'll be able to quickly start and stop the timer for anything you're working on. Your Clockify web app will then be updated with anything you track via extension. For more information about extensions, check out our dedicated video tutorial. The browser extension also allows you to track time on different tools and apps that you use on the web, which you can explore if you click on the extension icon in the browser and then click on the menu and choose integrations. You'll see a full list of Clockify integrations, and from there you can enable the ones you'd like to use or disable the ones that you don't. For the ones you have enabled, you'll see a Clockify button shortcut that can then start the timer directly from the app that you're using. For more details on integrations or more information on the features mentioned in this video, you can visit our website or help center. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.